like online shopping and bargains and stuff like that. And the second thing is that I know like a really ridiculous amount about sex toys. Yeah, this is my first time up here. You guys are actually going to learn like more than two things about the event. So the reason that I know all of this is because last summer I interned at a sex education center, and they're really amazing. They're in Providence, Rhode Island. They do like a lot of education and advocacy and outreach work, but mostly sex toys was like the takeaway everyone wants to hear about. So one weekend last summer, I was home in Philly, and I was sitting in my bedroom one night, minding my own business, when I hear kind of like a nervous, small version of my dad's voice coming in from the other room and calling me into the study. And I was like, something is weird right now. And so I went to the study, and indeed something was weird, because the first words my dad said to me in this moment were, "What is this in my Amazon cart?" And so what had actually happened was my mom was selling some books for me through my Amazon account that I didn't want anymore, and she had access to it and had left it open on the computer. And I am smart and forgot that my parents had access to this. And so I look at the computer screen where my dad is like trying to buy headphones or a fan or something. And in what he thinks is his Amazon cart is a really nice sex toy that we had in the center and is very popular and people really love. And I found it on Amazon for an amazing price. I'm also a procrastinator, is another thing about me. So I put it in the cart and was like, this is for later. I might buy this later because that's, right, that's the thing with sex toys. You might want it later, but not right now. So I saved it in there and my poor father is looking at it. And I came up with the best and fastest lie I've ever told in my life, and possibly the best lie anyone's ever told in a situation quite like this one. And I was like, oh, that's so weird, because I know how this happened. The other interns and I were looking up prices for some of the stuff we have in the center, and we were comparing Amazon to the sites that we recommend because stuff's expensive and people don't want to pay full price. And someone must have just added it to my cart by accident. Like, that happens a lot, you know? And you can just go ahead and delete that. And I went back to my room, and I was sure that even if my dad hadn't totally believed me, like, we weren't going to talk about this again. And we had both walked out of there with our dignity intact and, like, our relationship fine. Because also, like, I'm the youngest of three daughters, and my dad and I are close, and so I just don't... We don't want to have those conversations, but he is here tonight, so. So anyway, so I thought everything was fine until the next night. I'm in the living room with my dad, and he says, "So, about that thing in the Amazon cart," and I was like, "Oh yeah, okay." And I'm sure he knows, and he has lots of feelings about it, and he wants to discuss those feelings with me at length. And I prepared for a really uncomfortable conversation, but then my dad was just like, "I realize that I really don't know that much about what you're doing this summer, and like, I'm curious what you're learning about, and like, why you feel so strongly about it." And we proceeded to have a different uncomfortable conversation than what I anticipated, about, you know, all the different toys we have in the center and what they're for and why I think it's important that people know about them and use them if they want. And that was like a really important moment where I started to realize like just how supportive my parents can be of the fact that I want to like write and talk and teach about sex a lot in my life. And like without trepidation, they were on board, and that was really beautiful. But more importantly, I learned a very essential lesson about online shopping and bargains, which is next time, I'm just gonna buy it.